Self-fracture is a Blender add-on that allows users to fracture objects or create natural stone wall patterns. This add-on is especially useful when creating explosion, impacts, or destruction animations. Self-fracture analyzes the geometry of the object and fractures it according to user-specified parameters. This allows us to achieve effective results in both dynamic simulations and static visualizations. So, how do we activate this add-on? First, click Edit from the top menu of Blender and then go to Preferences. After going to the Preferences menu, we need to select add-ons from the categories on the left side of the window. Once on this page, type Cell Fracture in the search box in the top right corner, or you can just type Cell. In the result that appears, click on the box on the left side of the add-on and ensure this box is checked. Now we can start using the Cell Fracture add-on in Blender. I close this window. I go to Add an object to the scene. Since the cube is added by default, we can continue with the cube. I move the cube over the grids, and then I shrink the cube slightly. To use the Cell Fracture add-on with the object selected, I go to Object in the menu above. I go to Select the Cell Fracture option under Quick Effects. When you select this, a window will appear. There are many settings in this window. The default settings are adequate, but if it doesn't fracture as desired, you can adjust the source limit, noise, or other settings. Many other adjustments will also affect the object you want to fracture. I use the extra settings directly. I click the OK button and it applied the fragmentation effect. However, I desire a more intricate fragmentation effect, so I undo with Ctrl Z. First, we will put the cube object in edit mode and increase its geometry with subdivide. More surfaces mean more pieces. I go to object and select edit mode. I open the knife mode with Ctrl R and increase this number using the mouse wheel. I do the same vertically. Again, I press Ctrl R, move the wheel upwards and double click. We can repeat this process here. We have divided it this way. And you can right click and choose subdivide to divide it further. Now I repeat the previous steps, selecting all the vertices. If we select this way, the back won't be selected. So we need to select in wireframe mode. I switch to wireframe mode and repeat the selection process. I switch to object mode using the tab key as a shortcut. I go to the object menu, select quick effect and cell fracture, then click OK. As we can see, it has done more fractures than before. In fact, if you look at the list of objects, I go all the way down and it created about 100 fracture layers. We know where it got this 100 from. Since we set 100 as the source limit, it divided it into 100 pieces. This fragmentation process also resembles a wall. The dark areas are because it contains the original cube. We need to delete the original cube. In this station, we need to erase this cube. I'm deleting it and now we see a more realistic fragmented cube. You can enhance the fragmented objects here to create a beautiful wall. We have learned the basic use of the Cell Fracture add-on. I move the objects we fractured with Cell Fracture. To apply rigid body effects, we need at least two objects, active and passive. Active objects react to physical simulations, while passive objects are stationary objects that other objects fall upon and interact with. In this scene, the active object should be the cube, and the passive object should be the floor or plane. I'm creating a plane to better explain the fragmentation effect. We will anchor the fragmentation effects on the plane to prevent them from disappearing from our workspace. There will be an active object and a passive object. I'm assigning the plane the role of the passive object. I go to Object, select Add Passive under Rigid Body. And when selected and Play is pressed, it remains stationary. I'm activating these fragmented objects. We are going to assign in wireframe mode. So I switch to wireframe mode and make the selection. I select Object and Add Active. Now let's see its effect. As seen, the plane remained fixed and the fragmented objects touched the plane, showing the fragmentation effect. You can change its direction by pausing, restarting and making these selections. For instance, let's observe the fragmentation effect this way. I shove the fold this way and press play. Since the main topic of this tutorial is self fracture, I won't delve into its details. This is how to use self fracture in Blender. RigidBody settings are a powerful tool for simulating objects' physical movements in Blender. With the self fracture add-on, you can animate the parts you create with RigidBody, adding realism and dynamism to your scenes. In today's video, we learned how to install and use the self fracture add-on. That's all for this video. If today's video was useful to you, don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel right now. Just click on the subscribe button below this video. Thank you for watching.